Don't move, Synth. What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
I swear, I'm not a Synth. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family!
Put the gun down, now!
He's a Synth! He'll kill us all!
Kyle, no!
Oh, shit.
Okay, show's over. There are no Synths in Diamond City, hear me? Just you folks and your damn paranoia.
Well, that was unexpected. Oh man, this guy got fucking rocked. Look at all that. I'm taking his stuff though. Hey guys, welcome back to Fallout 4. Yeah, I just booted the game up. I was gonna take care of all the off-camera stuff that I mentioned last time first. But then this happened. Luckily I was recording, because I would have been pissed if I didn't get to show you this. I don't know if this is a random event. It couldn't have been random. It has to have been scripted, but people seem kind of stuck here now.
What's everyone still standing around for? Go back to your own damn business.
Yeah. People, what are you doing standing around? Just because some guy got his head blown off in the town square doesn't mean you got to make a big scene out of it. Jeez. Oh boy. Hey, here's Mo.
Hey, Mo.
Trying to take some time off over here.
Oh man, really? Oh, don't tell me everything's gonna close because it's nighttime. I gotta sell shit. Oh, my planning skills are terrible. Just terrible. Can I sit here and wait? If I sit on the stool and then we hit wait, it is 11:14. I'll tell you what, we're gonna wait about 8 hours. I think everything will probably be open back up by then, right? I see it ticks down. I like how you can see the light changing in the background, indicating that, you know, time is passing. Because the sun's moving. Alright, so now it's like 8 in the morning. Actually, it doesn't look like a lot of people are back yet. Fuck. I'll tell you what, we'll just wait some more. Guys, I'm probably gonna jump ahead until after I've done all my shopping business and whatnot. I'll be right back.
Need a swatter with a little more stopping power? Stainless steel nails, my friend.
Got any work?
Well, if you wanna help the sport, I got a lead on a stash of pre-war collector's items. Coach, quitting is for punks. Weston had an estate not too far from here. Legend says when he retired, the league presented him with a baseball, catcher's mitt, and playing card signed by all the other coaches. See where I'm going with this? I'll pay 100 caps each for those relics. What do you say?
Okay, guys, we're gonna try once more our persuasion.
100 caps seems light. I need more.
You think you can play me for a sucker?
Well, at least there doesn't seem to really be any, you know, negative consequences for trying and failing, so whatever.
A card, a mitt, and a ball. Got it.
I thank you. And baseball thanks you.
And that's what's important. So we got another quest from this guy. Yeah, 100 caps each. That'll help subsidize the cost of some of those swatters, because I gotta tell you guys, I thought about selling my police baton and buying a swatter. He had a really nice one that cost like 40% less AP points and did a lot of damage. But it was like over 1,000 caps. And that's basically all I have right now. I've got 1,198 caps, so I sure as shit wasn't gonna do that. Alright. Good news is I've got my weight down to 200, which is still like a little more than I would like for like looting purposes, but I think I need to use up a lot of the junk I have in my inventory. So what I need to do right now is find one of them there dang nabbit mod stations for a weapon. You think that like these people, this guy, is this a weapons workbench? Awesome. Alright, so right now I've got this. I don't know what all I can actually do on these. It already has glow sights. I think I already looked through all this. We're not gonna make any changes to that. The hardened double barrel shotgun. This does a little bit more damage. I picked it up at some point, and it's better than the other shotgun I was using. Can't do anything to that. The laser rifle. We can give it some improved sights. That'll use up some junk. Sounds like a good deal. We'll do that. The submachine gun, which I don't think I've actually even used yet. We could give it a compensator or a muzzle brake. Let's see, the compensator does improve per shot recoil, improve recoil control, reduce damage. Exceptional recoil control, better per shot recoil, inferior range. I'm okay with that, because the submachine gun, range isn't really what you're looking for on that anyway. So we will do that up. Let's see, the baton, can't upgrade that yet. And the short hardened pipe bolt action rifle. What can we do? Not much. We still need a lot more. I wonder if I should just, like, honestly just sell off a lot of the junk that I have, because it's just taking up space in my inventory right now, and I don't really have anything to use it on. Alright, but now that that junk is all taken care of, let's go ahead and keep looking around. I wanted to go see if we could talk to the mayor in this video. This place actually seems a wee bit smaller than I expected it to be when I first came in. I think we've pretty much talked to everybody out here. Everybody that appears worth talking to anyway. I guess this guy is just stuck here. Oh, those are chunks. Those are chunks of... Those are people. People chunks. Can we talk to this guy?
Hey.
He pulled a gun on me. My own brother.
He's dead now. I think he knows.
What happened?
I'm not a synth. I told him. I kept telling him. Why didn't he listen to me?
I need a minute.
All right, man. I hear you. That's a tough break. I will let you mourn in silence.
Officer?
I need you to step away, Scabber.
Scabber?
I understand, officer. I just want to know what happened.
You got bricks for ears? I said get the hell out of here now.
Okay. You know, the persuasion comes up way more frequently than I ever expected it would, so I'm absolutely gonna try and raise that next time I, level up. Did I talk to these people?
John.
Snip, snip, and bam, you're...
Right. No, I don't want a haircut. I'm good. Good on the haircut. Alright, so let's head up. Okay, I guess that's what they call the stands, where the rich people live. The rich assholes. I don't know if there's any more places we could explore in here. What is this? Alright, the elevator. Let's keep going up a little further. Let's steal something out of their mailboxes. That guy's an asshole. That's where the rich lady lives. What if we go up a little farther? Okay, that's a residence that we would have to pick the lock to go into. I'm not ready to get into all that just yet. Same with that. Okay, I'm gonna try this. I hope I don't die and kill myself. Hold on. Ah, perfect. And same thing, Hawthorne. Alright. So I don't know those people, and they don't want me in their house. Let's see if we can't call the elevator. It's already arrived. Is this the elevator? Okay. I'm moving on up to the east side. Hello. So there's two ways to get into the mayor's office. That's interesting.
Geneva.
Need something, honey? Housing permit? Looking for a job?
All of the above. Let's start with synths.
Wait, what was that about synths?
Oh no, I'm not saying anything. I like my job, thank you very much.
Okay.
And you are?
Geneva, the mayor's secretary. I handle all the day-to-day.
Alright, tell me about a housing permit.
Well, let's hear about the permit.
We have one home available. It's in the center of town, right near the market. You can do whatever you like with the interior, and all the tools you need to make your own furnishings are provided at no extra charge.
Cool. 2,000 caps. Can't really afford that right now.
Tell me more about this house.
The previous owner bought an adjacent warehouse and knocked down a few walls, so it's bigger than most. And he left behind his old tools, so you'll have everything you need to modify the inside however you see fit.
Man, I totally want to do that. I just can't right now.
Let me think it over.
Take all the time you need.
All right.
Hey, Geneva.
Need something, honey? Housing permit? Looking for a job?
Tell me about work, because these work options seem to lead to quests.
I'm looking for work.
Mercenary type? We usually have a few open bounties. Just check the wanted posters in the market.
Ooh. That could be cool.
I don't need anything.
Catch you later, then.
Alright, so what happens if I try and come back here and talk to the mayor?
Hey, officer.
No funny business around the mayor. Got it?
Alright. Nothing funny here. We are totally devoid of humor. I just want to say hi.
McDonough?
Excuse me, but I'm very busy right now.
Well, I'm trying to become a citizen. I would like to get to know you.
I have somewhere to be. Sorry.
You don't have anywhere to be. You're just standing there looking out the window like an asshole. Sounds like something a synth would say. Am I right? What if I hacked your terminal? You probably wouldn't like that. Okay. What's back here? I'm stealing from the mayor. What could possibly go wrong here? I'm surprised he hasn't come back and just stared at me. Look at this creepy shit. Why are these mannequins all over the place? One of these days, I'm gonna try to steal caps at the wrong time. That thing can change in a heartbeat. If you're not paying attention and somebody like walks up behind you, you go from hidden to detected. And you don't even always notice. Scissors and subway token. Alright. I really thought we would get something interesting out of the mayor, like some kind of quest or something, but that does not appear to be the case. Now, I do have a stealth boy, and I don't know, like, 100% what that is. I gather it's something that makes you really stealthy for a period of time or something. But I only have one. I don't know how rare they are. And I kind of want to hack into his terminal, because I figure there's got to be some really interesting stuff on there. But I'm going to wait until, like, I think I really, really need to use it. Because I have to assume at some point I could come back into this office when he's not here and do that.
Not to be rude, but I'm a bit busy here.
Busy with what?
Hi. Gotta keep watch on the gate.
Everybody says they're busy, but they're not doing shit.
Huh?
You all lie. That elevator must have a hidden loading screen because it's weird. I didn't have to load anything to go into the office, but I have to load to come back into the city. And it is a killer load time. Oh my god. Alright, so the mayor was a bus, but let's just look around a little bit longer anyway.
Hey, scavenger. Got plenty of Brahmin meat on the hook.
Oh yeah?
Wait, what kind of meat is this?
You never heard of Brahmin? Big, dumb, got four legs and two heads. They're the only cattle around. Everything's fresh from the Codman family farms. Sometimes, we get weird stuff from the caravans, too.
Weird stuff?
Weird stuff? Weirder than two-headed cow meat?
Yeah, Prince Charming. Weirder than that. Mirelurk bloat flies, rad stags. It's all protein, right? Ain't like you can be picky in the Commonwealth.
I'll be as picky as I want to be. All right.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Check out these cuts.
Okay, what do you got? Everybody has ammo, which is kind of hilarious. It makes sense, though. Oh, let's see. Lots of different meat. Most of it irradiated. Kind of hard to avoid that. Is that all you have? I was hoping you'd have some purified water or something. All right. I don't need anything that you're selling.
I can't believe you eat that food. Only one thing worth buying in the dugout inn, and that's the booze.
Yeah, it's gotta eat. What can I say?
A real Diamond City boy eats at the noodle stand.
Whatever you're gonna ask, I don't know anything about it.
Okay. Dugout Inn. Wow, this is a real place. I want to go in here. That's such a cool concept. Guys, I know I said Wrigley Field in the last video. This is actually Fenway Park. I knew that. I was just super tired when I recorded that video. I'm sorry.
Just a minute, Eddie. I am in middle of story. So then, I am crossing river, right? Wearing nothing but a smile. When out comes the most dangerous of all sea monsters. A Meyerlurk!
A Meyerlurk? Come on.
That's like 2 out of 10 points of danger tops. Now, if you want to talk something really deadly.
Redeem!
I forgot you were there, Yeti. What is it?
You know what? Never mind. I'll handle it myself.
Hmm. Apparently this is one of the guys that lives up in the stands. Which, by the way, that makes so much more sense now. That they call the rich area the stands because it's up high. Because they're literally the stands of the stadium. At first I was kind of like, why would they call the rich area the stands?
Oh, a customer. Need a room?
Oh, is that what this place is? I see.
What's the story with this place?
Not much to say. We sell food, drink, and rooms. Mainly for traders that come to the area. My brother Vadim runs the bar. Scarlett's our waitress, and she helps me keep the rooms clean. As much as they can be.
Nah, I don't think I need a room right now.
I don't think so.
Fine. But no sleeping on the couch.
I can't crash on your couch? I thought we were buds. Just kidding, I don't actually know you. If I come back here, does that piss people off? Guess not. I'm always really worried about doing the wrong thing in Bethesda games and, like, pissing off the NPCs. You know, you take the wrong item, you walk into the wrong area, and all of a sudden you're in enemy status and everybody's trying to kill you. At least in this game, most of that stuff seems to be denoted with, like, you know, it's red. A tuxedo? I gotta steal the tux. What does that do for me? Apparel. It increases my perception and charisma. So I should probably wear that when I'm trying to persuade people. Cool.
See this bar? I killed a man for it. No, I kid. He is dead. Now, let me know when you're ready to order.
I like this guy.
So, this your bar?
Damn straight it is. My brother Yefim and I make the best moonshine in the entire Commonwealth. We call it Bobrov's Best. Had to start renting out rooms just so customers had a place to safely pass out after drinking it.
Sounds like my kind of drink.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
That's what I like to hear.
Alright, what are you carrying? You've got ammo, beer, Bobrov's Best Moonshine, which is kind of awesome. Whoa, look at that. Charisma and strength go up, max HP goes up. Damn, intelligence goes down, but what are you going to do? And it costs 92 caps. Wow, things in this game are expensive, guys. Oh boy. We could buy some decent healing stuff here if we needed it. But we don't really right now. I've got plenty of healing stuff. It all just makes me sick.
Busy here.
Whatever you want, I ain't got time.
Hi there. You can order.
So it seems like people that you can talk to and have full conversations with have real names, and everyone else is just called resident. So let's talk to Scarlett here.
Miss?
Everyone just buys the beer, but we have plenty of other drinks if you're feeling brave.
Who owns this bar, anyway?
The Bobrov brothers picked this place up a few years ago. Vadim Bobrov is the loud one, Yefim Bobrov is the quiet one, and I'm the one that has to listen to them argue with each other all day.
Okay.
I'll think about it.
Take your time.
Hey, Scarlet.
If you're hungry, we sell food, but usually...
Let's see what you have.
Hopefully nothing will poison you.
Alright, she is also packing lots of ammo. Bobby pins. I need those. I always gotta buy all the bobby pins. Dirty water. And nothing else that looks super good. The Nuka Cherry and the Nuka Cola stuff is pretty good. That heals... The Nuka Cherry specifically heals 50 HP. But it's also really expensive. Everything's expensive. Jeez, man. It's ridiculous. I kind of want to know what's behind this door. I don't even think I'm allowed to try to unlock it, though.
Lock's really strong.
Yeah. Gonna have to buy those perks to do advanced stuff. Alright, let's try talking to Hawthorne here.
Hey there.
Hey. What's your story? Mercenary? Caravan guard?
Neither?
Wrong on both tries.
I can usually spot a hired gun on the first look. Maybe you just give off an armed and dangerous vibe. Anyway, I'm just kicking back and sharing stories while I'm between things. I've been all over, seen vaults, pre-war ruins, and plenty of monsters.
Tell me about these pre-war ruins. That sounds fascinating.
So you explore old ruins?
Last place I was going to check out was Salem. Real old town far to the north. Never made it, though. Got a bad feeling about that area.
All right. Tell me about the vaults.
You've been to a vault?
Yeah. Ever heard of Vault 81? They're standoffish, but every once in a while, they'll let new people in.
Let's check that out.
Let's hear your best monster story.
I'm from Diamond City. You want to talk something really scary? It's the Institute and their synths. Don't go to University Point. Trust me. You don't want to know what they're capable of.
Okay.
See you around, Hawthorne.
Yeah. Take it easy.
That's cool. Got some good map info from that guy. This person has a mohawk. That's kind of awesome.
Hey there.
Don't talk to me. It might attract someone's attention.
All right, I guess we've exhausted this place. I kind of hoped we'd get a cool quest from that area. Well, we got some map info, so it wasn't a total wash. Now,
if you're hungry, you can grab a plate.
There was one other place, Dr. Sun's house. No. I looked at the door earlier, and then I completely neglected to go in. There's a schoolhouse somewhere. Diamond City Radio. Oh, let's check this out. I doubt that there's anything interesting in the schoolhouse, but I want to be as thorough as I can be.
Hi. There.
Ah.
Travis.
This radio station? you'll notice there aren't any other ones. So...
This guy has some issues, I think. Is that all you got? I can't talk to you at all?
Hey, Travis.
Okay. I usually don't... This is why.
Okay, I'm just gonna leave that guy be. Take a look around for bobbleheads real quick. Yeah, we're good.
Hey.
Whoops. Alright, haven't spent a whole lot of time looking around these outskirts yet. Might be some more interesting stuff. Let's look over here.
Chang, what have I told you about keeping the lake clean? Don't make me shut down this little stand of yours.
Every drop of water that comes out of that filter is 100% pure. Why is a legitimate businessman like myself always gotta be hassled by city regulation, huh?
It's a health hazard, Chang.
It's a profit hazard is what I say. I manage the water, and I'll do it without your interference, thank you very much.
Hey, I think those Bobrov brothers are looking for you.
They are? Thanks for the info. What's your story, little man?
Purified water. You won't find this out on the Commonwealth.
I definitely already have, but okay.
You by yourself out here?
That's right. Been on my own since I was 8. I'm a fully independent man. Got my own place. Go to night classes. The whole shebang. Now, how about I get you a bottle of water, huh?
Maybe.
Let's see what you got.
Best decision of your life.
I do like purified water, but at 61 caps a pop, See, I don't know. I know that's the kind of stuff you can find when you're out exploring, so I'm reluctant to spend caps on that type of stuff.
Hi there.
Don't drink that irradiated crap out there.
Pint-sized? Anything I can do to help out?
Ah, the industrious type. Want to help me clean out the water supply? You won't believe the junk people throw in there. Overloads the filters.
Depends. What's this worth to you?
Job's 100 caps, but I like you. 125.
Fuck yeah! Oh, we can try again? Dare we be greedy? Oh, why not?
Come on. My time's worth more than that.
No. We're not doing this. 100 caps for the job. No hacking.
Oh, no. I just lost the 125, didn't I? Damn it. Well, that's a lesson in being greedy, I guess.
What kind of stuff is down there?
You're looking for big things. Anything around the size of a book, usually.
All right, sure.
I'm on it.
Just don't drown. I'll never clean your carcass out of there.
I like this kid. He's got his shit together. Alright, so we've got another quest to help him out. Cram. I think that's supposed to be a spam parody.
Fresh water here.
Which I like. I like spam, guys. I don't know about you. It is kind of gross, but it's also delicious. Alright, let's see if we can't find that schoolhouse. I should have went in the first time I saw it. And what is this active quest leading me towards? I don't even know what quest is active right now. Where the hell am I? What is that? Get me over the fence, damn it! Ugh. Hello? Wonder why this thing's here. It looks like it was... I mean, it looked like it was hiding something, but it's not. Maybe that's the house they're gonna sell me.
Don't let down the home team. Buy a squatter.
Ooh, it was a greenhouse. Moe's house.
Diamond City Surplus. Everything you
Valentine Detective Agency. You know what? This is actually where I was going to go before we ended the video. I think that's where that Nick Valentine guy is. And I wanted to do that quest to talk to him, but let's go in here first. Okay, we got some mutt fruit I can harvest. I'm still surprised that I'm allowed to just take that stuff. It's like the most valuable commodity in the whole world is like food and the ability to grow your own food. I just walk around hijacking all of it. Alright, not much else going on in here. Ooh, I'll take that, though. Alright. Okay, I don't know where the schoolhouse is, but we'll hit it at some point. It's probably not a huge deal. Let's go in and talk to Nick Valentine. Before we talk to her, let's come up here and see what we can find.
The photographs. He never did photograph well.
I'm sorry to steal from somebody that I think I'm gonna like.
Detective secretary. I'll never find another job.
But I need this stuff. I'm a wastelander. And I have no scruples. Alright, talk to me.
Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
But it's important!
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, miss. It's important.
You don't get it. The detective, he's gone. Missing.
That's a problem.
Do you have any idea how I could find him?
He disappeared working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
Okay, here we go.
Hey, I'd love to help, but there's a small matter of expenses.
Don't play games with me. I'll pay you if you find Nick, but it's going to be 100 caps. That's the reward, and it's not up for negotiation.
Great.
Who's this Skinny Malone character?
I don't know much about him, but he's from Good Neighbor, and that means he's in the well-pressed suits and machine gun school of thuggery.
So, this is going to be a tough job, is what you're saying.
You said Malone's from Good Neighbor?
Yeah, it's a tough neighborhood. Northeast a ways. People with power there care about two things. Style and body count.
Okay.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.
I'm going to make that my number one priority, actually. Jewel of the Commonwealth completed. Cool. Yeah, I had to be straight up with you guys. Through osmosis, I know that that guy is actually a really cool character and will be a lot of help to me. So I kind of want to do that as soon as possible. Let's read this. Includes the Zeta Invaders holotape game. Awesome. I'm taking that. Can I really do this right next to her? She's not looking at me. Oh man, that's intense. I can't believe I got away with that. Anything else? A couple more caps. Alright. I really want to save up and buy that house. I know I could just make a house over at, like, Sanctuary, where I actually have a settlement started. And it already feels like it's been forever.
Wow, you're tall.
Yeah, who are you? Hey, get back here.
Well, hello.
You shoot people, sir? My dad says outside is shoot people.
Only if they piss me off. But yeah, it's been a while since we went and checked in on Sanctuary. I wonder how my peeps are doing. I probably won't be back for a while either, because I've got shit to do.
Yeah, it's true.
Science Center.
Long story.
You got shot in the ass.
Officer?
You're getting pretty chummy with that reporter, huh? Careful there. The mayor's got it in for her.
Alright. Let's check out the Science Center. This sounds awesome. I wonder what passes for science in the apocalypse.
We have a new theory about how the Institute makes the synths.
Oh no. We've been talking about this, remember? After last time, the shouting, me sleeping on the cold floor of the lab for 3 nights.
That was your choice.
And seriously, growing synths from the ground using recombinant plant nuclei? I mean, how could they even...
Aha! You do want to talk about it.
Oh, look, we have a visitor. Dr. Duff, dear. If you could bother them while I walk away from this conversation.
Hi there! Are you here for today's free biology lesson?
What?
Biology lesson?
That's right. Usually the kids from the schoolhouse are the first to drop by, but I don't see why I can't start the lesson with you. Now, we all talk about radiation like it's a single thing, but it's actually a term referring to dozens of different ionizing rays. You have X-rays, beta rays, gamma rays. But which one are we most worried about? The one most associated with the big old bombs 200 years ago?
That would be gamma rays.
Gamma rays?
That's right. Now, gamma rays are bad, really bad. If your body absorbs too much of that kind of radiation, you'll suffer from fatigue, anemia, even death. But some life forms have been living with gamma radiation exposure for 2 centuries now, and they've adapted. Neat, huh?
That would be the ghouls, right?
What kinds of things have adapted to radiation?
Oh, that's the perfect segue into the field trip portion of the lesson. Are you ready?
Sure, let's do it.
Sign me up.
You're gonna go out and find a bloatfly gland.
You see, the oversized bloat fly of today evolved from an earlier species of a smaller fly. Radioactive adaptation has resulted in a unique gland that enables it to balance and maintain speed despite its size. So what do you say? Ready to go out and dissect one?
We're going to ask for money to go on a field trip.
I do a job. I get paid.
This isn't about money. This is about science. You got to do it for the love of exploration.
Okay.
Get the blowfly gland. Got it.
Remember, bring the gland back in one piece. Oh, and don't chew on it. One of the students got horribly sick because of that mistake.
All right, we got a quest to get a bloatfly gland. I don't know why I didn't do this like an hour ago. If I'm going to be talking to people and doing all kinds of fucking persuasion checks, I should be wearing stuff that will actually help me in that endeavor. The tuxedo should, and is it the Ushanka hat or the welding goggles? God damn it. Hold on. Which one gives me better persuasion? It's charisma, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, so actually the hat doesn't matter, but the tuxedo should help. So it gives me plus one. I don't have anything else that raises my charisma. At least not yet. How does that look? That looks creepy as hell. Wearing the tuxedo with the gas mask. Oh man. I like it though. So can I... Nope, that's a master terminal. What is that? Undamaged camera. That's probably worth something.
Dissecting a bloatfly can be fun. Just avoid getting stung to death, and you'll be a junior scientist in no time.
Oh, thanks for the pro tip.
Dr. Duff.
Enjoy the field trip.
I refuse. What happened to that other lady that was up there? Hold on, what's in here? Oof. I get nervous every time I do that. There's an armor workbench. I still haven't really messed with all that. That's another thing I gotta do. Oh, she's sleeping. Ooh, she's got good stuff here. Mine. Mine. Mine, mine. Mine. Ooh, I was detected for a second there. Let's quick save it. Mine. Mine, 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 mine. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Wait, who detected me? See, that's what I'm saying. I was detected for just a split second there. Fashionable glasses. Go away. I want the glasses. Go away. Who is looking at me? Got him. Your glasses are mine. And you have no idea who stole all your shits. It definitely wasn't the guy in the weird tuxedo and gas mask who came in here and hung out for a minute and then left. No, sir, under no circumstances. Okay. Well, that's cool. We picked up another fetch quest. All right. Any other trouble we can get into in this place? Dr. Sun's house is now open.
You look a little roughed up. Should talk to Doc Crocker over at the Mega Surgery Center.
Why would you say that to me? I have full health right now.
I'm not supposed to talk to people I don't know.
My hey, sweetie.
Smell. You don't smell at all.
Stop talking over each other. That's annoying. Earl Sterling's house? And we're back at the dugout inn. Home plate. Requires key. What the hell is this place? Oh, this is probably the house that's for sale. Home plate. That's cool. I'm totally gonna buy that place. As soon as I can.
Probably not.
Hey, here's the schoolhouse.
I came into town. I picked up a weird
I just really wanted to come see this place. It was gonna bother me if I didn't find it in this video.
Ain't you a little old to be in school? Yesterday.
And we've learned a lot since then, so we're going to reinforce that knowledge with a little quiz.
But I'm tired.
I'm detecting a high degree of fatigue in all our little scholars. Perhaps the quiz can wait?
All right, you guys win. We'll do the quiz later.
Yes!
You pussy, don't let the kids push you around. What are you doing?
Sorry, you're in the wrong place. This is a school, not a store.
A school, huh?
Yes, every child in Diamond City gets a free education here. We even teach night classes if they have busy day schedules. I'm afraid you're a little old to be enrolling here. Doubt you'd fit in the seats. But it's a public building, so feel free to look around. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to my lesson plans.
Uh-huh.
Mr. Zawicki.
It's true.
I'm quite busy with the students, but feel free to look
so
around.
So happy seeing you all grow and a new scholar come to join us. Let's test your math skills. What is 12 times 15?
12 times 15, 180.
Is it 180?
That's right. I see your parents raise you with a respect for your education. Family. It is important, yes? This thing called love, I hear the children talk about. I think they need that to learn.
I have no idea how to answer this. I'm gonna say structure.
I think they just need to know the world isn't gonna collapse around them at any minute.
Yes. I suppose you can't raise a child if the sky is falling. I have one more question before you leave. It's not another quiz. I don't get to talk to many adults. This love I hear about, do you think you can have it for someone, even if the two of you are very, very different?
Love conquers all.
If you love someone, hold on to them. Tomorrow you might not have the chance.
I thank you. You have helped me make up my mind about something.
Oh, we helped the robot. She's gonna find love. That's fantastic. I feel really good about myself now.
I don't know. I'd rather be a security officer. That way I can hit people.
Guess we can go out through the roof. That was actually pretty cool. I'm glad that we found that. I hope there's some kind of follow-up with that later. Like, Edna's gonna propose to Wellingham or something. Although, I hope that Wellingham dies before she can do that, because she doesn't deserve to be with an asshole robot like that guy. Screw that guy. Dude, I'm like Batman running around the roofs up here. Alright guys, I think we've pretty much thoroughly exhausted Diamond City at this point. Let's go ahead and take a look at our quests. Unlikely Valentine is the one that I want to follow. We've got a ton here. The active one right now is to talk to the settlers at Ten Pines Bluff. Gonna be completely honest, I don't even remember picking that up. I have a vague memory of it, but I don't remember where we got it from. But we will make that active. We will make that not active. And if we hit show on the map... I wasn't on the right one. Hold on. There we go. Find Nick Valentine. This UI is so from like 2001. It's like really hard to navigate. So where are we right now? That's where the quest is. That's Good Neighbor. He's supposed to be somewhere around there. And we are here? Right. So we're gonna head east, and we've got a fair amount of land to fight through to get where we're going. But that's what we're gonna get started on next time. Thanks for the support, guys. I appreciate it. I'm Dude Long Couch, and I will catch you guys in the next part. I'm Batman.
Hey there, mister. My dad says not to talk to strangers.
Okay.